Efficiency is perhaps the most important concept I'll teach you in this course, so make sure you understand it before moving on. Efficiency, also called complexity, is how well you're using your computer's resources to get a particular job done. You can normally think about it in terms of space and time. How long does your code take to run, and how much storage space do you need? Let's think about efficiency in terms of cutting hair. Normally, your hair would be snipped off in clumps, and you would just compare some strands you cut to a group you're about to cut to approximate where your next cut goes. However, you could cut one strand of hair at a time and compare each strand to a ruler or measuring tape to make sure the exact same amount gets cut every single time. That's ridiculous, though. It would take a crazy amount of time, and it really doesn't matter if hair is exactly precisely cut. If you could use less time to get the job done pretty well, then you're good. Often, the trade-offs for algorithm efficiency are similar. You could take a slow, methodical approach, but there's often a faster method that accomplishes the same goal by reducing repetition. Efficiency can rely heavily on your creativity and your ability to get the most done with minimal resources. But there are a lot of known tips and tricks that you'll be expected to know in a technical interview. An interviewer will expect you to know some common data structures and the efficiency of doing basic things with them, as well as some knowledge of specific, well-known algorithms. In this case, an algorithm is just a series of steps for solving a problem. One of my favorite moments in my programming career was the first time I used an algorithm to improve my code. I had a function that took hours to run on this huge data set, but after applying an algorithm, it only took seconds. Writing really efficient code can come off with another trade-off between time efficiency and space efficiency. What if your code could run in just a fraction of the time by storing temporary values in a new data structure? For that decision, you would need to weigh whether the time of the person using your code or the amount of memory needed is more important. By the end of this course, you'll have most of the tools and knowledge you need to make efficient code.